page 479. First and last, onward, Christian soldiers, as the choir comes down on the last. Would you stand?
Onward, Christian soldiers, marching as we go.
Let's have the young people come. Let's shake hands one with another, all right? Glad you're here. We're glad that you're able to be in God's house tonight. Let's make the best of it. And I told the men in the prayer room that every afternoon, every morning before service, we're getting texts about people that are not well and not able to be here tonight in the house of the Lord. But we're glad you're able to be here and welcome Brother Gordon tonight. We mentioned his wife in the prayer room. She is home, and we thank the Lord that got her home. And then we welcome Miss Susie Wagner. Miss Susie, was you here this morning? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't even realize that, but we're glad you're better and able to be back in the house of the Lord. And the Dickey family right here, glad y'all are better. Glad you're able to be back in the house of the Lord. I think it's kind of taking turns going from one family to another. But listen, this might be the last service you're in for a while, so let's give it our very best, all right? I'm serious, give it our very best. And they're short-handed, but let's amen them anyway, all right?
All right.
appreciate the old time way, don't you? That's what this church is. I hope this church will always stay that way with the help of God. Amen. Thank you, choir. Thank you, adult and youth choir, and all the musicians as well. We appreciate it. Quickly, let me give you some announcements while you're getting your tithes and your offerings ready to give unto the Lord. Monday night, if you'd like to go, there's going to be a delegation of men that leave the parking lot over here at about 5:45. Service starts at 7:30. Going to Mint Hill, North Carolina, just beyond Charlotte down and before Monroe. And Brother Pastor James Knox will be preaching there, and that starts at 7:30. By the way, we have Brother James Knox booked for our Jubilee this coming year and in 2023. But you'll love him. He's great. So 5:45 tomorrow night if you'd like to go. And then Tuesday night from 6 to 8 right down the road here at the Skaters Skating Palace or Skating Center is the Fall Festival. And listen, we're eating at 7, all right? We're eating at 7. So if you want to get there for eating, you come at 7. And everybody's welcome to come. It's free. No cost to anybody. It's taken care of by the church. And there'll be food. There'll be fellowship. There'll be fun. There'll be candy bags and just all good things. And we exclusively lease the center just for the church. And so we can play our Christian music and not the worldly music. And so that's why we do what we do. And we make no apology for that. So if you like skating to the Inspirations and the King James 1611 boys and the Primitive Quartet and the Owens family and Mary Beth and the young man, everybody else, and some other Southern gospel, come on, all right? Enjoy the good time. 7 o'clock Wednesday night. 7 o'clock Wednesday night here in the church, all right? Now, while the ushers, come on, y'all, if y'all will. Remember Miss Gordon, she's home from the hospital. Brother Gordon's wife, home from the hospital. Pray for her. Remember Dinah Emery, who broke her leg. Please remember Dinah Emery. Remember Rhonda White, she's having surgery this Wednesday. Miss Rhonda White. And remember then Miss Abby Humphreys is home. In a lot of pain all night last night. Miss Abby Humphreys, want to pray for her. And very important, Miss Lily Blackwell goes in 2 days for some further testing and imaging and things like, I think that's right, imaging, other stuff as well. Pray for Lily Blackwell, okay? And there's a horde of others, but I know these things are important. They're all happening the first of the week, all right? God bless you. And listen, go ahead and give your tithe, give your offering. Don't miss a week for the glory of God, all right? Go right ahead, Tiffany, please. Can you come pray? Can you come pray? Bless his heart. Didn't know he's up there by himself. Joey and them sick. Chris and Perry sick. And little Quincy sick. And just on and on and on. There's so many others that are not well. And I hope they, by the way, we're still having school. School starts right back at 8 o'clock in the morning. If your child has a fever, it'd be very, very good for you to keep that child home so we can try to stop some of the spread of this if we can, all right? Brother Philip, pray for us, if you will, please.
Father, Lord, we love you tonight. We sure do thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your grace. Thank you for salvation. Lord, it's good to be saved tonight, Lord. It's good to be a part of the family of God. Lord, we thank you for our church and our church family. Lord, we do lift up those that are sick tonight, those that are not able to be with us, those that are having a hard time. I pray, Lord, you touch them. And, Lord, more importantly than that, God, I pray for those that are sin sick tonight, Lord, as our pastor mentioned. Lord, we got a lot of folks not doing well, Father, Lord, and our heart breaks for them. And, God, I want them to do better. Lord, I want our church to be back where it needs to be. I want our folks to get serious about this thing of serving God. Lord, we desperately desire you touch, Father, Lord. Realize it can happen to us tomorrow. God, I pray you'd help us to draw nigh to the Savior. Thank you, Lord, for the promise that if we draw nigh to you, you draw nigh to us, Father. Lord, we love you. God, we lift up these tithes and offerings. Thank you for blessing us like you have. Lord, you've been good to the Mountain View Baptist Church, Father, Lord. And least we can do is give you back a little portion of what you gave us. Father, bless our pastor tonight. Fill him with the Holy Ghost. I pray you'd unctionize him from on high. I pray, Lord, he'd rear back and preach to a lost, dying world. Lord, I pray you'd get a hold of us tonight, dear Father. Lord, help us to get serious about this thing. Lord, we're living in these last days, in these wicked days. And, Father, Lord, we need to cinch up in these areas, Father. I pray you'd help us. Get a hold of us tonight, Father. Meet with your people, Father. Lord, all is vain unless the Spirit dwells with us tonight, Father. We ask you to help us tonight. Bless those that need your touch. In Jesus' name, amen.
Him a moment to get back up to the sound booth, and this crowd's going to get ready behind me. So while they're getting ready to him go up there to get the mics ready, we have two devotional books now available every month, and they're put out by different churches, and both of them are church oriented, local church oriented. And so they're here, they're on the side tables. I personally have both of them, and I like, and honest, what I do, I'm just going to tell you, I read both of them. Because I like to compare what both books are saying, Brother Randy, for a daily devotional. So those two are available. And you got the electronic one, Brother Rick Ivester's, if you'd like to do that each day. He'll put you on the mailing list. And then we have the voter guides. And listen, we can gripe, we can complain, we can bellyache, we can fuss, we can get all upset. But as Christian people, unless we do our part, and that's voting, then there ain't much we can say, all right? So we encourage everybody to be registered to vote and hold fast to the right, amen, hold fast to the right. But we have some voter guides down here. They'll be a blessing as well. Well, those are pretty self-explanatory, but they're available. Lastly, before they sing, appreciate Brother Stephen Long, Brother Jared Spencer, been in touch with the appropriate personnel, been in touch with the appropriate people about the Red Cross. And just so you'll know, in a nutshell, what the issue is their width was 24 inches. We went to 36 in the vertical and the horizontal piece. We went to 36, and they want us to stay at 24. And the problem is the 36 inches has already been fabricated. So, we're only talking 12 inches on us, Brother Randy. 12 inches, and they want to turn us down on the 24 versus the 36. So, we got some guys that know some guys that hopefully we all know the Heavenly Father, amen? And you prayed about that. We just want to get a favorable response, and we want to go up with it like it's already been fabricated. We made it wider and just bigger, all right? So that's the issue. It's 12 inches. So pray, make that a matter of prayer, okay? All right, I'm glad this crowd's singing. You worship with them all.
Could be the hour we've been waiting for. This might be the dawning of that day. When the trumpet sounds and all the clouds roll back, and we see the King of Glory as the saints all start to praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him for the blood that made us free. Just in case this is the hour of our Lord's return, oh, I'd like to be found praising Him for saving me. Eastern gates, out singing, praise Him, praise Him, praise Him for the blood that made us free. Just in case this is the hour of our Lord's return, oh, I'd like to be found praising Him for saving me. Is the hour of our Lord's return. Oh, I'd like to be found praising Him for saving me.
Amen.
Great, great, great. Thank you, thank you. You say amen to that? Well, I noticed that guitar there is about as big as Malia is. God bless you, Malia, playing the guitar. Thank you, Donna. Thank you, Brian. Appreciate it. Thank you, Brother Jimmy Owens. God bless you. I reckon some of Jimmy's crowd's sick. I don't see Crystal, and we'll leave somebody out, but there's just a lot of people that's being affected by this sickness, and I'm thankful that some of you are better and able to be back in God's house tonight. Now, I want to ask you a question before I preach tonight, and I know most of you will know something about it, and that's biblical typology. Biblical typology. A type can be an event, A type can be a ritual, a ceremony. A type could be, Brother Pye, could be a person, an individual, like an Aaron, the high priest, a type of Christ. Or a type could be an object, something tangible. And tonight, believe it or not, what we're going to read, then bring the message, Miss Tanya, is based on biblical typology. When you have an object or something, Brother Paul Wallace, that represents or is a picture, or is, Brother Randy, a representation of something else than what is actually stated. Take your Bible and go back to Exodus 33. You'll understand that now in just a moment. Exodus 33, that sounds good, Brother Philip. I appreciate it. And let's really concentrate tonight. Let's do that. Let's concentrate on God's Word. That's why we're here, to be fed from God's Word. Amen? From the Word of God, not a puppet show. Not a drama, not a skit. No, not a skit. Not necessarily a political essay. We focus on God's Word. You grow with God's Word. You mature with God's Word. And I love God's Word, don't you? Exodus 33, verse 21. And the Lord said, now listen, I could get hung up a long time right here. Behold, there is a place by me. I like that. Oh, my Lord, wherever that is, whatever that represents, I'd sure like to know. I found that place. Amen. There's a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. Probably a mountaintop, right? Probably a mountain, Brother Randy Jr. And verse 22, and it shall come to pass, while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in a cleft of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand while I pass by. And I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not be seen. I want to preach tonight with the help of the Lord on in the cleft or in the cleft of the rock. I want to define, look at your Bible. Now listen to me. There never has been and there never will be a mistake in the Bible. Never has and never will. So look at your Bible and look at verse 22. It is the word cleft, C-L-I-F-T. Now all of our life, Brother Tommy Kirker, We've heard cleft. So honestly, I have no explanation why it has that letter change right there. However, I will tell you this. They are identical, all right? Whether it's the cleft of the rock, Brother John Cudd, or the cleft of the rod. What is the cleft of the rod? Well, it actually means a long, narrow crack. It means an opening along the surface. It means to dig or to pick out. Listen to this. I didn't make this up. I didn't make it up. It means to pierce. To pierce. I wish I had a Bible reader. To pierce. It means to thrust out a hole, a crevice. It means to be, listen, I didn't make this up. It means to be smitten. It means to be riven. Riven. Are you getting me now? The cleft of the rock. Amen. The cleft of the rock. Could I tell you today that Moses was only allowed to see a partial unveiling of God's glory and God's person hidden in the cleft of the rock? God passed by, and what glory Moses saw, he saw it only as he was in the cleft of the rod. Ladies and gentlemen, in biblical typology, I want to say to this audience tonight that the rock, the cleft of the rock, Brother Dallas, it represents none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. On Christ, the solid rock, I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. I'm glad tonight I know something of the reality, and I know something of the experience of being on that rock. Amen. And by the way, that rock is so sure. That rock is so steadfast. That rock is so stable. I will never lose my salvation. Thank God for the rock. Amen. And Christ, by the way, is the smitten rock. Christ is the pierced rock. Christ is the rock, the cleft of the rock, the division in the rock. You say, what do you mean by that? He was smitten. Amen. And he was, as it were, pierced. All right. Thank God he was smitten for me. Thank God he was smitten for you. By the way, he was smitten of God. Amen. He was smitten of God. I'm glad he laid down his life. I'm glad he willingly shed his blood. I'm glad, thank God, he went to a place called Mount Calvary and there shed his blood. And watch me, they pierced his side. I said they pierced his side with the spear, and forthwith there came out water and blood. I want to tell you, friend, there never has been such great love as was manifested on the place called Calvary. I say to this church tonight, may we stay near the cross. May we live under the shadow of the old rugged cross. It's despised by the world. I said it's despised by the world. But hey, it's got a wondrous attraction for me and a wondrous attraction for you. Upon the cross is where the Prince of Glory hung and died, become our substitute, became our sacrifice, became our Lamb of God. Thank God he who knew no sin became sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Nobody ever loved you like Jesus did. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I say to this audience tonight, thank God Jesus Christ is the smitten rock. Amen. Let's study our Bible. Take your Bible and go to Exodus 17. Exodus 17, quickly. Bible typology. Exodus 17, if you will. And look at tonight and verse number 3. Exodus 17 and verse number 3. And the people thirsted there for water. And the people murmured against Moses and said, wherefore is this that thou hast brought us up out of Egypt to kill us and our children and our cattle with thirst? And Moses cried unto the Lord, saying, what shall I do to this people they be almost ready to stone me. And the Lord said unto Moses, go on before the people and take with thee the elders of Israel and thy rod, wherewith thou smotest the river, take in thine hand and go. Watch this now. Behold, I will stand before thee there upon the rock in Horeb, and thou shalt smite the rock, and there shall come water out of it that the people may drink. And Moses did so in the sight of the elders of Israel. What do you mean, preacher? I'm saying the people thirsted and the people were going to famine. And Moses took a rod, Brother Bride, and he smote the rod, and out came that which satisfied and that which quenched their thirst. Hey, friend, the smitten rod in Exodus chapter 17, it's the same smitten rod that took place on Calvary. Say amen. Take your Bible and go to 1 Corinthians. Go to 1 Corinthians since you... in your Bible tonight, go to 1 Corinthians. I need to prove to you about this Bible typology. 1 Corinthians chapter number 10, please. And look, if you will, and verse number 2. And we're all baptized unto Moses in the cloud and in the sea, and did all eat the same spiritual meat, and did all drink the same spiritual drink. For they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. Is that what your Bible said? That rock was Christ. Go to Psalm chapter 18. Go all the way back to Psalm chapter 18, everybody. Psalms 18 and verse number 1. Look, if you will. I will love thee, O Lord, my strength. The Lord, in Psalm 18, 2, the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength in whom I will trust, my buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower. Go to Psalm 40. I'm hurrying on purpose. Psalm 40, and look at verse number 1. I love this right here, Brother Derry. Psalm 40, verse number 1. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me. He brought me up also out of an horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock, and established my going, Brother Cam. And I love this. It put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Where did he set your feet? He didn't set your feet on slippery slopes. He didn't set your feet on sand. He didn't set your feet on marble. He didn't set your feet on limestone. Thank God he set your feet upon a rock. Amen. And that rock, that smitten rock, that cleft in the rock, that high tower, hey friend, that solid rock, is none other, thank God, than Jesus Christ our Lord. Thank God you can't move him. I said you can't move him. You can't get under it. You can't get above it. You can't get around it. He'll always be there for you and I. Amen. Take your Bible and go to Song of Solomon. Folks don't know this is here, so I need to show it to you. Song of Solomon, all right? You go to Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, get to the end of Ecclesiastes, and you start the Song of Solomon. Look, if you will, at chapter 2 and verse number 14. Quickly now, Song of Solomon 2 and verse number 14. Oh, my dove, listen to this. This is the beloved talking to her. Oh, my dove, thou art in, listen to this, you'll love it, in where? The clefts of the rock, amen. In the secret place of the stairs, let me see thy countenance. Let me hear thy voice, for sweet is thy voice, and thy countenance is comely. Where was the Shulamite? Where was she found? Where was she located? Where did he find her? He found her, Brother Kyle, in the clefts of the rock. Hey, look at me. That's where you are. That's where the church is. That's where the saints of God are. Thank God saved. Thank God secure. Thank God satisfied. Thank God stable. Thank God stable. Where? In the cleft of the rock. Amen. Go, if you will, to two other scripture. Well, three. Let's go to Matthew 7. I don't apologize for the Bible. A lot of scripture this morning and a lot of scripture tonight. But listen, a lot of scripture are not going to hurt anybody. It won't hurt anybody. Matthew 7, if you're taking notes, write all this stuff down so you can show somebody. Matthew 7 and verse number 24. Matthew 7, 24, therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. Somebody needs to say amen. I like this, Brother Randy Jr. This is what happened now. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the wind blew. And you know what, Brother Brian? I've had the rain, I've had the floods, and I've had the wind, and it beat upon the house, and it fell not. Hallelujah, I could preach right here. And it fell not. Why? For it was founded upon a rock. Amen. You know why you're here tonight. You know why you're here, in spite of the wind, in spite of the rain, in spite of the flood, in spite of the adversity. You know why your house has not collapsed. You know why your spiritual structure, you know why your spiritual structure has not caved in. I tell you why. It's built on a rock. Amen. Hallelujah goes right there. Look at Matthew 16. A lot of folks don't know this scripture's here. Matthew 16, please. Listen, I ran every one of these references Friday too, Thursday, forever got here. Matthew 16, verse number 17. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. Well, what did he say? Drop back to verse 16. Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Verse 18, And I say unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock, not Peter as the Catholic, let me help with some doctrine, right? Not Peter as the Catholic Church supposes, but the rock that he's talking about is the acknowledgement of the deity of the Son of God. That thou art Christ, the Son of the living God. Brother Paul Wallace, the Lord turned around and said, Upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevent it. What's the rock? The rock of the person and the deity of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know why there's a church here? After all these years, you know why there's a church here on the side of I-85 on 1650 Battleground Road? I tell you why. It's not founded on me. It's not founded on Dr. Roberts. It's not founded on anybody else. It's founded upon the rock. And the rock is Jesus Christ. Thank God for stability. All right? Take your Bible, last scripture, 1 Peter chapter 2. I hope you'll enjoy the Word of God. I hope you can appreciate your scriptures tonight. I love the Bible. Thank God for the Bible. Now, if I was Brother Biddle, I could have quoted all of them. Or if I was some other Brother Sammy Allen, I might could have quoted all of them. But I really do like us to turn, Brother Philip Griffith, and just see for ourselves what God's Word said. Hey, look up here. We ought to be like the Bereans anyway. We ought to search the scripture whether those things are so. In other words, what I'm saying, are they so? Guess what? They're so, according to God's Word. 1 Peter chapter 2, if you're there, say amen. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse number 2, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the Word that you may grow. Verse 3, so be you have tasted the Lord is gracious, to him coming as unto a living stone. A living stone. Disallowed indeed of men, but chosen of God and impressed. By the way, you also, as lively stone, are built up a spiritual house and holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifice acceptable to God by Jesus Christ. I want you to look in verse 4. It's talking about the Lord. It's talking about Jesus Christ, the living stone. Amen. Go back to Exodus, all right? Go back to Exodus 33. We'll quit with all the scripture right now. I think I got all of them. Well, I didn't go to Deuteronomy 32:4, and I didn't go to Numbers 20. But same thing. By the way, there was one occasion, Brother Dallas, where Moses, instead of speaking to the rock, he smote it twice. And when he smote the rock twice, Brother Brian, God said, you're not going into Canaan. Why? Because he broke the type. He broke the type. The rock doesn't need to be smitten but one time. Come on, help me now. You Sunday school teachers, all right? The rock doesn't, he chastised Moses, Brother Wofford, because he smote the rock twice. And he was supposed to speak to the rock, and that's a number. And God said, you're not going to Canaan. Listen, the rock doesn't need to be re-crucified over and over. I could run a little rabbit right there. That's what transubstantiation is all about. Transubstantiation is the heresy. I said it's the heresy of the great harlot. Somebody ought to help me right there. The Roman Catholic Church on earth. He said, why do you call it the great harlot? You know why? Because they do merchandise, the Bible said, in the souls of men. That's in the book of Revelation. See, listen, you know what? We just need to read our Bible a little bit more. Look it up. They merchandise in the souls of men. That's right. Yeah, they don't care about the souls of men. But anyway, they have a doctrine they call transubstantiation, that when they take communion, that the wafer turns into the actual body of Christ, and the cup of juice turns into the actual blood of Christ. But that would be crucifying him afresh and anew. And can I tell you something? He doesn't need to be crucified afresh and anew. Brother Dickie, Miss Dickie, he was crucified some 2,000, y'all helping me, okay? Some 2,000 years ago. And guess what? That's been sufficient all these years. And it's still sufficient. He only had to be crucified one time. Amen. And when Moses smote the rock twice, by the way, for your information, that is, let me get my notes here. I believe that's Numbers 32. That was Numbers 20. When he smote the rock twice, and God said, you shouldn't have done that. Because I'm telling you why. He said he broke the type. He broke the type, and I don't take time to do all that tonight. But go back to Exodus 33, and we'll finish here. Exodus 33, verse 21. And the Lord said, behold, there's a place by me. That, by the way, that speaks of fellowship. Amen. That speaks of communion. Brother Doug Pye, honest, there's not a whole lot I want in my life. There really isn't. There's just Brother Mathis, Brother Miss Sandy, there's not a whole lot I want in my life. Brother Galloway, I'd sure like to be found in that place by him. So that I can enjoy fellowship, Brother Tony, and I can enjoy communion. And I want to tell you something. Here's what I'm convinced of. You know, the brother prayed. I alluded to it in the prayer room. We've got a lot of people physically not well. But I'm going to tell you something. As a pastor, with concern in my voice and in my heart, we've got some folks that are not spiritually well. Not spiritually well. And you know, we're as close to God as we want to be. If we want to draw nigh to God, then nobody's stopping us, and nobody's stopping you but yourself to draw. But this, but that. Listen, there's nobody stopping you to draw nigh to God except yourself. Make every excuse you want to make. You and I are as close to God as we want to be. We read our Bible as much as we want to. We pray as much as we want to. We love church as much as we want to. Or we miss church as much as we want to. Listen, I don't know where it's at in your life. I don't know. You don't know where it is in my life. But I tell you this, there is a place. There is a place. There's a place, and I love this right. By me. By me, Miss Jenny. By me. Wouldn't you like to find that place? Wouldn't you like to know him more? Wouldn't you like to enjoy companionship and fellowship and intimacy? Wouldn't you like him to say, I know thee? By the way, I could re-preach every bit of it. I know thee by name. By the way, I didn't develop this morning, but Moses said, Lord, you haven't told me who's going to go up with me. You haven't told me who's going to go up with me. The Lord was saying, I know your name, and I'll give you grace. What he was saying is, I'm going with you. And not only that, Brother Troy, I'm going before you to fight your battles. Listen, Charles. The Christian life is still the best life that anybody could ever live. That anybody could ever live. Hey, I'll take Jesus, amen. Miss Pat, God bless you. Good to see you all the way back up from Florida. I know you feel the same way. I'll take him. I'll take this life. And I just want to say again tonight, wherever that place is, wherever it is, hey, why don't you do your best to find yourself in that place? Find yourself in that place. I want to say this to our hearts tonight. You prayed for me, and the Lord's given me great liberty up here, and I appreciate it. But listen, if you desire to draw nigh to God, He will draw nigh to you. The problem is, Brother Gordon, is we're not drawing nigh enough. Look at the verse, Miss Ashley. And again, pray for Nathan. He's up there, and bless his heart. He's got to drive. It's about 5 hours. Nathan's preached all day. Bless his heart. Got to drive all night. Did you come back tonight? That's a lot of traveling to be home 1, 2 in the morning, maybe 3. But pray for him, please. He'll stay awake and be safe on the road. But look at your verse. Verse number 21. He said, behold. When you find that word behold, you better slow down a little bit. You better pause a little bit. Behold, Brother Andy, there's a place by me. A place by me. I'm going to preach that one day. I'm just going to preach on that verse right there. There's a place by me. Oh, God. I'd say it's the best place you've ever been to. I'd say it's a place you better hang around. I'd say, I'm going to help you. I'd say if you haven't found it yet, you better hurry up and get in a hurry. And you better find it. And I'd say this, you better linger there. I mean, you better linger there. I knew I'd get hung up here. I knew I would because I knew it'd preach in me, all right? There's a place by me. I love every one of you. I love every one of you, but I'd rather be by him than by you. I enjoy your fellowship. If I go tomorrow night, we'll have the best time. Lord God, dear, great preaching, great singing, and great Waffle House, you don't get any better than that. Clogging up your arteries, you can't improve on that. Amen. We went the other night. We went a little personal stuff, right? We went the other night to hear Brother Mark Stroud up here at Faith, and had a great service, great preaching, great singing. We was all in one vehicle, and as usual, the cruise control was set right to one destination. It wasn't Mickey D's. It wasn't Burger King. It went straight to Waffle House. It didn't veer to the right. He could have put it on cruise control, closed his eyes, took his hands off the steering wheel, and that vehicle would have wound up at Waffle House. So we all started ordering. Brother Doug, I think, started it out. He got a big old blueberry waffle. I said, Lord God, that looks good. It was so good, he convinced Brother Randy. He said, I want a waffle too. We had a time. We enjoyed the sweet fellowship, the fixing, and of course we had grits and eggs and toast and just all that. I mean, it was just sweet fellowship. And I enjoy the sweet fellowship. I mean, I enjoy the sweet fellowship, but I want to tell you something. As much as I enjoyed it, as much as I appreciate it, there's a fellowship that this world knows nothing about. They're not looking for it. They're not hungering for it. They don't care about it. Brother Kyle, it's not even on their mind. And I want to say humbly, Miss Donna, Brother Brian, I found that place a few times in my life. Brother Rick, I found that place. What help? It helped my heart. It helped my mind. It helped my spirit. I suppose it helped my body. There's a place by me. There's a place by me. If you haven't found it, you better find it. And when you find it, you better cherish it. And you better guard it. And you better hang around a little bit. You better hang around. Listen, when we went to Waffle House the other night, and by the way, you're all welcome to go. You're all welcome. And if we have to, we'll put some folks in the back of the truck. I mean, we'll have a great time. We'll take a bus if we have to. But you're all welcome. Anytime we announce these meetings, I need to say something. Anytime we announce these meetings, there's no certain few that are allowed to go. Everybody can go. Everybody. If you want to go, go. If we have to take two or three cars, we got money, we'll buy some gas. And we'll go. Amen. And some of you have never been. You've never been. I mean, and I'm not fussing, but you've been to three times church and you've never been to an extra meeting. You've never been to another church meeting. Listen, it's just different. It's just good. You hear another choir, you hear another preacher. You go to another church, you go to another city. It's good. It's just good. Amen, everybody? Amen? It's just good. So don't ever feel left out. Just show up. Get in the vehicle. We won't make you drive by yourself. You'll go with the group of us. And you'll have a good time. If you know what? We could commandeer the King James Boys bus. And we could even get a bus driver to boot. And put it on their charge account. Somebody ought to help me. Somebody ought to help me right there. Who'd pay for the fuel? Randy Jr. paying for the fuel. I suppose if we really got in dire straits, I believe you would let us use your bus, wouldn't you? I appreciate it. I mean, we only got four, but we might need yours. It's a place by me. Sometimes, Brother Gordon, sometimes I don't even have words to say. I just sit there and ask him to speak to me. Sometimes, Brother Marty, I got an open book right there with me. I got an open book right there with me. Folks, this Christian life is a relationship. It's a relationship. Look at verse 21. Behold, there is a place by me, and I'm of course not stopped there, but let's keep reading. Thou shalt stand upon a rock. And that's where you're standing. That's where you're going to keep standing. And it shall come to pass, verse 22, while my glory pass by, that I will put thee in the cleft of the rock. I'm gonna put you back in that huddled out place. And let's keep reading. I'm going to cover you with my hand. Lord God, this is beyond me, folks. This is beyond me. I'm going to cover you with my hand while I pass by. And I will take away my hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shalt thou not see. Brother Galloway talked to me this morning after the service. He said, Dr. Jack Green, Evangelist Jack Green, I'm not sure if he ever preached here, but I'm sure you heard of him. Preached for years. He said that the sun is so bright, so luminous, so brilliantly bright, it hurts to look directly into the sun. It hurts the human eye, Brother Dickey, to look directly into the sun. Towards the evening, Brother Walford, that sun begins to set. Beautiful sun begins to set. And you see the last remaining minutes of that setting sun. You know what you're catching? You're catching the hinder parts. You're catching the afterglow. Wish I had my coat on. You're catching the afterglow. That's what was going on right here. Thank you, Brother Brian. That's what was going on there. This rock, and I'm finished. This rock is a place of permanence. Permanence. It's called a rock. Permanence. This rock is a place of protection. I'll put you in the cleft of the rock, sheltered from the dazzling light. And maybe, yes, and I know this is right, Brother Clifford, from the devouring fire of God's glory. I'm protecting you from the dazzling light and the devouring fire of God's glory. I read that this morning. The devouring fire of God's glory. I'm securing you from any wrath that may come, that may consume you, because you're not able to handle all of that glory at one time. God protects those who are therefore hid. Where? Hid where? In the cleft of the rock. This rock is a place of permanence. This rock is a place of protection. Protection. We're standing on a rock. Our salvation, Miss Jenny, is on a rock. We'll say, what if I fall off? Can't happen. The rock's too expansive. Tony, the rock's too big. The rock reaches in, the rock, Brother Garrett, reaches in every direction. You're not going to fall off. It's a rock. Permanence. Protection, Brother Dale. Protection. And I'm protected from their judgment, the wrath of God. I'm protected. Listen to this. I'm protected from Satan's assaults as long as God wants me to be protected. Number three, the rock is not only a place of permanence. The rock is not only a place of protection, but number three and finally, the rock is a place of privilege. Yeah. A place of privilege? Oh, yeah, a place of privilege. Because where Moses was, not only was there permanence, and not only was there protection, but Brother Mathis, there was privilege. What do you mean? He was privileged to hear and see something that some folks in this world have never seen. Show me anybody else in all the Bible that was able to see God's hinder parts as they passed by. Can I tell you something? In Christ, come on to the choir. Come on. Let's do, I think it's 476 maybe. 496 maybe. I looked at her. He hideth my soul. You look under that title. He hideth my soul. Can you play it, Jada? He hideth my soul. Thank you, sweetheart. I appreciate it. Listen, a place of privilege. What do you mean? We get to experience things. We get to enjoy things. Brother Joseph, we get to see things. We get to hear things in Christ. In Christ. That the world knows nothing about. Thank God tonight. Thank God. Look at me, everybody. Thank God that we are situated on the rock. On the rock. Let's do, what number is that? 496, you're going to need a book. We've heard it over and over all these years. Let's sing it in reference to the scripture. You ready? Let's stand. Let's sing two verses. He hideth my soul. Where? In the cleft of the rock.
A wonderful Savior.
Come on, come on, come on.
Is Jesus my Lord?
Come on, sing now, sing.
A wonderful,
come on, y'all.
Savior to me.
Sing it like you believe it.
He hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock, where rivers of pleasure I see.
Sing it now.
He hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock.
That's where Moses was.
Shadows a dry, thirsty land.
He hideth.
He hideth my life.
In the depths
of his love. And covers me there with his hand.
His hand.
And covers me there with his hand.
One more verse. One more verse. Sing it now.
A wonderful,
sing it, sing it.
Savior is Jesus. My Lord,
sing it.
He taketh my
hallelujah.
Away.
We ought to be shouting. We ought to be shouting.
He holdeth me up.
Permanence.
And I shall not be moved. He giveth me strength as my day.
Everybody together now.
He hideth my soul. In the cleft of the rock,
Brother Wofford,
that shadows a dry, thirsty land. He hideth my life in the depths of his love
and covers me there with his hand. His hand
and covers me there.
Now, y'all are laughing, but you know you liked that repeat. You know you did. I didn't do it right, but I did my best, all right? How many enjoy the Word of God tonight? I appreciate this book right here. This is our manna. This is our manna. Okay, now, we got a busy week.